This is Suck, Squeeze, Bang, Blow, and today in the shop, we are going to have a look at the brand new version of MSD's latest ignition, the 6AL-2. Here's the scoop. Everybody knows this MSD box right here. It's the 6A or the 6AL. The 6A is a regular multi-spark capacitive discharge unit. The 6AL has a single-stage top-end rev limiter in it. But that box that we've seen forever has now got a new and upgraded version, which is this, the 6AL-2, which is a digital unit with a few extra features. The first thing that you'll notice when comparing these two boxes is that the new one is about an inch shorter in length than the old one. It's also a little bit more than a quarter of an inch difference in height, although the overall width at 4 inches is the same. The other difference here is that the 6AL has a single stage top end rev limiter, whereas the new 6AL-2 has a two-step in it, meaning you can have one rev limiter at the line for your launch control and another for your top end rev limit. The 6AL is an analog capacitive discharge unit, whereas this one is all digital. Now that allows a couple more things. For example, the old unit, you needed that little chip to shove in the side in order to control your rev limits, whereas on the 6AL-2, you just pop these little rubber plugs off of the top, and with a tiny screwdriver, you can get at these dip switches here in order to adjust your rev limit for both your first and second stage of RPM. The other sort of cool feature is here by the dip switches, there's also a little tiny status LED. And under 3000 RPM, this will blink if the unit is not seeing at least 9 volts, because it's really important to get full power to those MSD units. And that will tell you if you're good or not. Price-wise, the new digital 6AL-2 is about 50 bucks more than the original 6AL, but not only is it digital and smaller and lighter, but you also get that two-step, and it is cheaper overall than if you were to buy the old two-step control unit that plugs into the old 6AL. Also, this wires exactly like every MSD unit that you're used to, but the new 6AL-2 will control a Hall effect ignition, whereas the old 6AL analog unit will not. And speaking of wiring, all the basics are right here on the back of the unit so that you can never forget what to do. And the better news is, the old unit's that way too, so when you pedal it at the swap meet, the next guy can know what to do also.
Installation of this is really easy. Most of you guys are going to mount it to the firewall, but we decided to put it in under the dash. You've got black and red going to your battery power. You've got a red that's going to your hot ignition source. A wire that's going to your tack, and then black and orange going to the coil. It's only going to take you a few minutes if you've got a billet distributor like us. The other thing that's easy is happy little MSD plug, you're all set.
Chad made these little brackets so that we can mount the MSD up under our dash without having to drill any new holes. And we always use these little feet that come with the MSD, little rubber vibration mount, so it doesn't shake the unit when it's in the car.
Because there's nothing worse than shaking your unit.
David was making fun of my brackets and wondering if I really should tighten everything up, but I know this is going to fit the first time. Watch that. Right there. And you doubted me. That's the beauty of the unibit. You just drill a really big hole. One of the other advantages to the unit is that besides it being smaller than the old one, it also puts off less heat. And since we're mounting it inside the car, that's good.
And it makes more power.
Oh, and it makes more power. So not only is it smaller, but it puts off less heat and makes more power, both of which are good things. Just gonna snug this thing up.
We're ready to wire.
The wiring's going in this just like they said it would. On the crusher before, we had the switch 12 volts coming from the key over to the coil. And I'm simply tying into that wire out under the hood.
You want to run the power directly to the battery. There's a switched ignition power, but then there's also heavy wires for both power and ground that'll go right to the battery. When wiring an MSD, it's really important to braid the purple and violet wires that go into the magnetic pickup on the distributor so that they don't transfer signals to each other. But we're doing the power wires here just kind of for convenience and appearance. And look how trick that is.
We're using a piece of welding rod as a fish tape so that we can drag this wire through the fender. But as a guy who's built a lot of Camaros, I can tell you that if you drag said happy metallic object through fender and touch battery cable,
you will weld that to the inner fender well.
Yes, so avoid that. We got a couple of our connectors done so that we can hook our 12 volt keyed source up. And now I'm hooking the wires to our Blaster 2 coil. This coil, as you all know, is the standard, just like the 6AL was. So this new 6AL-2 hooks right up to it, just the same as always, with an orange wire and a black wire.
We had the battery disconnected for the whole installation, and I have about 80% confidence there will be no fire, so I'm hooking it right back up. And I pulled the distributor out when I installed that billet unit, as opposed to the old ready-to-run that we had in it. So the timing's gonna be real questionable right now. So we will crank it until it backfires a few times and then set the timing roughly and then dial it in flawlessly with this here timing light. Okay. It's idling at 1,000 RPM. I've got 20 degrees initial in it because I put a really, really light spring in the MSD distributor. We got 35 degrees total, and that's good for what we're doing. If I was driving this thing around on the street a lot, I'd probably have less initial and put a little bit of a slower curve in it for 91 octane, but since all we're gonna do is drag race for now, we're set to go. We got it running and got the timing right now, and so Chad's gonna check the two-step rev limiter. The blue wire just needs 12 volts to activate, and so we're gonna fire it up, activate it, and then rev it up to our 3,000 RPM setting and see if the thing's got the soft touch action going on. Ready?
Yep.
Fire it up. Yep.
Right at 3 grand.
Right at 3 grand. So that's what we're gonna use to launch the car. You wanna go test it on the street?
Yes.
Of course you can. Okay, let's go.
Let's move it up. Two-step. It's trying to drive through the brakes at 3.
This converter is just too tight, which is the same problem we had at the track.
Yeah.
I think when you change the converter, we'll be able to step it up, but I'm going to pull it down to like 25.
Yeah, I think that's perfect.
Okay. That works much better at 25. That converter's too tight, though, so next time you see the Crusher Camaro, we're going to be throwing a loose California Performance Transmissions converter in it. Watch for that on the next episode of Speed Wrench.
Oh.